Okay, there we go. If you hear me talk a little louder this morning, we're recording now. And what we're doing is we're posting my messages on our social media pages. And we posted our first one last Sunday. But I had to type in there, I said, if you really want to hear the whole thing, put your headphones on. So I'm trying to get the volume correct on this. And once we get this down in future weeks, we're going to work on a way to plug it through the sound system so it records at the same volume and everything is in great shape. This morning's message comes from 2 Corinthians chapter 5, verses 16 through 21. Let's dig into God's word for us this morning as we learn about being happy and knowing it. From now on, therefore, we regard no one from a human point of view. Even though we once knew Christ from a human point of view, we know him no longer in that way. So if anyone else is in Christ, there is a new creation. Everything old has passed away. See, everything has become new. All this is from God, who reconciled us to himself through Christ and has given us the ministry of reconciliation. That is, in Christ God was reconciling the world to himself, not counting their trespasses against them, and entrusting the message of reconciliation to us. So we are ambassadors for Christ. Since God is making his appeal through us, we entreat you on behalf of Christ, be reconciled to God. For our sake he made him to be sin who knew no sin, so that in him we might become the righteousness of God. Thanks be to God for his holy and written word this morning. Let us pray. God of compassion, you welcome the wayward and you embrace us all with your mercy. By our baptism, clothe us with the garments of your grace and feed us from the table of your love through Jesus Christ, our Savior and our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forevermore. Amen. I often tell real life stories of certain people and how they witness to their faith and how they portray going through life and growing in life by growing in their Christian walk. For me, the gospel of Jesus Christ, the word of God, is most active when we know how it relates to our daily lives and how it relates to God's people, not only in the past, but today, right now, right this very moment. This week, I went to Facebook and I asked a question on Facebook. And this question was, help the pastor with his sermon and respond to the following question. If you could go back to your 20-year-old self or your younger self, what would you tell your younger self from your standpoint today? Well, I had a wide variety of answers. Most of the responses were people telling their younger selves not to worry so much and also to know that you are loved and that you are accepted. They also informed their young selves to take God with them now and that he will see them through. So how do I sum up these social media answers, these social media responses? I break them down into 2 points. Dear younger me, do not worry as much. Place your faith and your trust in God through Jesus Christ for your happiness and the ability to know when you are happy. And as we sit here this morning, Pastor's going to ask you, are you happy? And do you know it? Recently, I have been listening to a CD titled Songs Under the Air Conditioning Unit by Dennis Parker. Dennis is an award-winning country musician, having played with country artists such as Tracy Lawrence, Joe Diffie, and Ricky Skaggs, who Ricky is a Kentucky native of Eastern Kentucky. In between the music, Dennis speaks about his journey with his father and with alcoholism and his arrests due to alcoholism. And finally, the body of Christ, people, and a loving God for saving him from the grip of addiction. Now, I met Dennis W. Parker. Lynn, as my gift of celebration when you all called me as your pastor, got me tickets to see Ricky Skaggs and Kentucky Thunder at the Kentucky Bluegrass Museum. And so, just so happened to be that Ricky Skaggs and his band were staying at the same motel. And Dennis W. Parker and some of the band people were in the breakfast room the very next morning. And you want to know what happened? These men, these musicians, turned a hotel breakfast room into church. We had worship. No, not like the traditional worship setting. We didn't sing songs, but we sure did talk about Jesus Christ and what he can do, what he is doing, and what he will do in our lives. Well, we see through Dennis and his stories of the horror addiction that God's people and a loving God have freed him from the captivity of addiction, and he can truly say that he is happy today, and he knows it. Yes, today's texts from our lectionary are all about happiness. They state that we should rejoice. Listen, we should rejoice. We should celebrate in happiness because. And here are some things why we should celebrate this happiness. We are happy as a people whose sins are forgiven because of the cross of Christ. We're happy as a people who have become righteous because of God, through the merits of Jesus Christ. We are happy as people whom through the grace of God have rolled away the disgrace of former times. We are happy as the Father at the return of the prodigal son. And happy are people in the fact that our sins have been forgiven for Jesus' sake. Thanks be to God. Today, in our text, we see the Apostle Paul giving a strong message to the congregation at the church in Corinth. He is telling them about how true transformation occurs, how newness of life occurs, and how all our histories can be reconciled because of Christ's resurrection, overcoming an earthly death. Let's take a look at this morning's text. Friends, for us all to understand this morning's text, we must go a couple verses before this text and understand what Christ did for us out of love. And that love is the true motivation and the true happiness that we obtain. Additionally, we are taken back to the sacrifices in the Old Testament as to truly understand true sacrifice of Jesus Christ for us. In the Old Testament, unblemished lambs were sacrificed, and in the New Testament, Christ, the Lamb without blemish, was sacrificed for our sins. He died so that we should no longer live for ourselves, live for the world, but instead live and love for God and God's people. Start with verse 16. From now on, therefore, we regard no one from a human point of view. Even though we once knew Christ from a human point of view, we know him no longer in that way. What the Apostle Paul was telling the church at Corinth and what he's telling us this morning is that knowing true happiness can only be found in and through Jesus Christ. He is telling them that the flesh and the world cannot and will not truly satisfy. And he is telling this church, and he's speaking to us this morning, telling us that living for ourselves and what the world will gain us must cease. And living for him that died and rose again is our path to true fulfillment and true happiness that is eternal. Prior to becoming a Christian, Paul persecuted Christians. He lived for things of the flesh. What do you think Paul would go back and tell his younger self if he could go back in time? I think Paul would tell himself to stop looking at things through the flesh and instead look at things through spiritual eyes, things of God. Verse 17, so if anyone is in Christ, there is a new creation. Everything old has passed away. See, everything has become new. Beloved, being in Christ is by having that personal relationship with him and all of us giving our lives to him. In Christ, we are justified by his grace. We are baptized into Christ's death, and we all have been given a newness of life. We are sanctified, dead to sin, and alive in God. This is the true happiness that we know we have been given and which we are called to live. In the New Testament, the fulfillment of these Old Testament prophecies. Yes, the New Testament is the answer. It's the promise. It's the response to these Old Testament prophets that carry us forward to the knowledge of happiness. You see, when promises are kept, often people are happy, and we know that the Father keeps his promises. How many times in our life has somebody that we trusted, loved, knew, promised us something, and they failed to come through with what they promised? Well, what Paul is saying today is, don't worry about that because God keeps his promises. And sending his son, Jesus Christ, to the cross and to the tomb, which would be empty after the third day, is the fulfillment of those Old Testament promises. Prophecies. Yes, our God keeps his word. Verse 18. And this is from God, who reconciled us to himself through Christ and has given us the ministry of reconciliation. Paul is telling us in this verse that happiness, true happiness, and knowing this happiness involves change. And this change, this transformation, this reconciliation is something that we cannot do ourselves. It is something that we must be with God in personal relationship and to rely on him to help us in that new life, to help us reconcile, to change. You see, here's the difference between the world and God. Unholiness is of the world, and holiness is of God. True happiness and knowing it involves reconciliation, coming to peace, and coming to terms with something, letting the old go as to enter the new, to feed you and to fulfill you. For people of Christ, this is done in the following ways. Forgiveness, justification, or redemption. This means understanding that these things take place when we receive God's forgiveness of our sins. Grace. We are fulfilled when we are given the undeserved favor of God, the gift of salvation through Jesus Christ. Justification. Through Christ, we are made just and we are made righteous. Only the justified can be admitted into the presence of God. And reconciliation, understanding that we are a new creation and made servants. We understand that this newness and happiness of life wants us to reconcile further by our services of ministry and outreach to all of God's people. Verse 19. That is, in Christ, God was reconciling the world to himself, not counting their trespasses against them, and entrusting the message of reconciliation to us. This tells us that God has assigned Jesus as his personal agent. And Jesus, as God's personal agent, is called for carrying out God's master plan, which we know that Jesus will carry out and fulfill. Verse 20. So we are ambassadors for Christ. Since God is making his appeal through us, we entreat you on the behalf of Christ to be reconciled to God. Often we refer to ourselves as the body of Christ. But here Paul states that we can also be referred to as agents of Christ, meaning we do not make the messages, but instead we share the messages to the world as God's people, as agents of the gospel, as agents of our risen and resurrected Savior, Jesus Christ. We also understand and know that true happiness is knowing that because of the life, death, and resurrection of Jesus Christ, his people are given justice and they are given righteousness. Those who are faithful receive God's righteousness, justification, and grace through the gospel of Jesus Christ. And I made this formula here. GR plus J plus G times GJC equals F. So what does that mean? It means that God gives us all of these things as his people. And the outcome of this newness, this justification, is done by our faith in him. So God's righteousness plus justification, plus grace, times the gospel of Jesus Christ, equals faith. Beloved, just as the song states, it already said, you're happy and you know it. You can clap your hands. You can say hallelujah. But we are happy and we know it because of Jesus Christ. I conclude this morning's message. I contacted Dennis W. Parker, and I said, Dennis, if you could go back to your 20-year-old self, what would you tell your 20-year-old self? And this is what Dennis Parker sent me and what he said. If the Lord is not the center of where you are heading, and he is not the first, then all it you have is the pursuit of yourself. It is meaningless. It is a meaningless endeavor. A hamster on a wheel in a cage staying in one spot. Don't follow the world's ideas of success. Follow Jesus. Have a servant's heart. It's the most rewarding life anyone can imagine. Serving others, who would have imagined? And Dennis answers, but that's the truth to true happiness and knowing it. So how do we leave this place today? We go out into our special places today or tomorrow and said, you know what?